as I've started to learn more about pro audio equipment, specifically your stuff, it's not always for that extreme saturation why you'd use a tube. Can you talk about why you use tubes in your gear?
Say we're talking about a big power amplifier, and we had dynamic range that wasn't all killed off by the world's compressors and limiters, you know, and you have some very quick transients, like the strike of a piano. You know, if you've got all the signal is mainly like this, and then you have this big spiky transient, because you have all that headroom, you're not gonna hit that piano and it goes, you know, like if you hit a digital over in your A to D, you know about it.
Yeah.
It's either good sound or completely not usable, right? Imagine if your A to D, if you could push the limits like that and you kind of sort of wouldn't really hear it. That's what we're talking about with vacuum tubes. Take the Manley variable mu, right? You know, you can purposefully overdrive the input to get a little bit crunchier sound, not crunchy, just kind of fuller, thicker sound as a color choice, right? And again, this is using gear on the extremes that we're talking about, but you can use it where you're just looking at the extremes a little bit, just to get a little bit more flavor and color into your sound on purpose.
And if you had to describe what that flavor is on a physical level, what is it?
It's kind of thicker.
Talk about the science behind it. This harmonic distortion is kind of what we're talking about. Is that right?
Yeah, well, there's a lot of misconception in the world about that. You know, if you're getting even order harmonics, structured distortion components versus the odds, and that would be, to explain a little more, you have your primary frequency, and then if it's a doubling or tripling of the frequency, it's the odds or the evens, right? And so the even components are generated usually from a single-ended circuit topology, as opposed to push-pull circuitry, which uses complementary pairs in transistor land, or, you know, can use a plus and a minus supply with tubes. Like the variable mu is a little push-pull circuit, so its harmonic structure is actually more odd order harmonics, not even.
Okay.
So it's, again, if you put them up on a bench, say you put up a Manley variable mu, which is push-pull, versus a Manley L-up limiter, which is single-ended, you'll see the difference with the harmonic structure right away.
Yep.
So you'll see that, say you're doing 1K, you'll see 1K, and then the next harmonics will come up at 2, 4, 6 on an L-op, say single-ended circuit, or 3, 5, 7 on your odds, right? And so they do sound different, but we commonly think of the even order harmonics as kind of rich and luscious and beautiful sounding, as opposed to the odds.